So, after a tiny bit of persuasion, I've decided to respond once again to Maoist Rebel News 2.
Well, some gay atheist still needs attention.
Right, because you kind of made response videos to me within 12 hours of me uploading my responses to you. I mean, for one thing, I find it strange that when I uploaded my video to you and posted as a response to yours, all of a sudden you reply to me, yet when it's somebody who has a much larger sub count and audience than you, you all of a sudden slink away and wait a while to reply to them. But when it's, you know, somebody whose videos usually get maybe 70 views, roughly, you jump all over them.
Do I need a holiday in the DPRK?
Do you know what that was, Maoist? It was a play on words of a title to a Dead Kennedy song. In fact, one of your little fantards even mentioned the guy who fucking wrote the song. I mean, I guess you don't understand how clever titles work, so, you know, maybe you'll fucking start talking about the Berlin Wall or something now. I mean, the song was called Holiday in Cambodia, where they make fun of sheltered, privileged fucks like you, who sit there and defend brutal, totalitarian regimes that do horrible things while they know nothing about it. And so I took the word Cambodia and replaced it with North Korea. Because I'm a clever little fuck, aren't I?
Yeah, I do. I'd love one, actually.
So why don't you move out of that nice area in Canada you live in? I mean, if you love North Korea so much, how come you haven't done that? Just curious.
So now when you quote sources, you're quoting blatantly anti-DPRK books? That's, pretty dishonest.
If I said they're pro-DPRK or fair portrayals of the DPRK, then I'd be lying, but I didn't. I just said I read them. And it's funny how you say they're biased, and which they are, but you sit there and act like, oh, that's, you know, bad, when you quote sites like antiwar.com to talk about drone strikes. Just a bit curious.
And then taking a source from a U.S. government program that's designed to talk about other countries with relation to religion.
That was actually from the United States Commission on International Religious Freedom. I guess you can't read, but yeah, I actually do read my own sources. I'm not fringe elements.
Are you serious? Atheist?
Are you so fucking stupid that you don't realize that someone can be an atheist and, say, a secularist and believe that people should be left alone and allowed to believe whatever crazy shit they want and shouldn't have the government saying forcing one sectarian belief on them over another? Or am I supposed to be some douchebag and have state-enforced atheism and support that?
All that stuff about the one-party state? Actually, you were implying that it was a one-party state.
Yeah, the reason why I said the Korean Workers' Party controls the communications and media in the government is because that source that you keep refusing to go look at, I guess, or dismiss offhand, you just ignore it. That says all domestic and international communications are controlled by the Korean Workers' Party. First fucking line in the section on telecommunication. I'm sorry I read books and government reports instead of fucking Wikipedia, like you.
And you know what's actually really goddamn stupid to claim that Juche is the religion of the state?
Yeah, it was. I misspoke. I meant to say ideology, but, you know, who gives a shit? Because there was alcohol in my system, and I really wasn't fully thinking. So, yeah, you're kind of right when I said that. But here's the thing. I would like to ask Mr. Communist how North Korea, where they have a military-first policy and where their government officials get, you know, a shit ton of more preferential treatment over, you know, say, the ones working on the collective farms and shit, you know, the proletariat, how the fuck does that fit into your communist worldview where, you know, the military and the government officials and everything get better treatment than the fucking workers? How does that fit in?
By that logic, I can turn around and say that capitalism is the religion of the West.
All hail Henry Ford and the assembly line. It is our God.
Do you even know what logic is?
I'm starting to wonder whether or not you know how to fucking read, to be honest.
Oh, and once again, you're strawmanning me. The personal army thing was about the videos were being made, not the comments in the comments section.
Right, I really don't recall it happening that way, but, so then I guess, you know, you still have a personal army considering that Jim Pro, whatever the fuck his name is, Bolshevik, sat there and sucked your dick in the first part of this video and then proceeded to sit there and say I'm some crazy ultra-capitalist libertarian.
Those are completely irrelevant. I get more hate in a day than you'll probably ever experience in your pathetic life.
Yeah, I can't imagine why you'd be hated, considering the fact that you're, you know, subscribing to some shitty economic belief that doesn't fucking work. And you'll sit there and like the gay rights page on your personal Facebook account. And also, you'll like yourself on your personal Facebook account. But you'll like that gay rights page, and then you'll sit there and say, I'm only gay to rebel against my parents.
I'm gay and an atheist. Take that, Mom and Dad!
That doesn't sound like something someone who's a gay rights supporter would say. Oh, and when you sit there and make comments about how you're a communist, yet, once again, you know, you said someone's stealing your content, when, if you're a communist, you believe that's the belongs to everybody. Oh, and when you're a communist and you sit there and promote privately owned enterprises, when you're somebody who sits there and screams at his neighbors, I can't imagine why you're hated so much. You're just such a fucking hypocritical, lying douchebag that I'm beginning to wonder why I'm replying to you, other than the fact that I might have to do it 9 months from now.
Well, by the way, I see your little comment here.
Oh, this is gonna be great. Oh, since we're sitting there, you know, spying on each other's personal shit, I took the liberty, like I already mentioned, to spy on your personal Facebook page. Yeah. You like fucking Hannah Montana. What the fuck?
Never talking to me again? That's kind of funny, because you just made a video.
Well, you know, I have to renege on that, because you kind of opened yourself up for this too fucking well. Yeah, and that comment, that was on the video I just made, so unless you want to say me and the user Jim Jesus, who I was replying to, could comment on the video before it was fucking uploaded, you're either lying or you're so stupid that not only can you not get the order of events when it comes to the Korean War right and the foundation of the DPRK, you can't even get what's right in terms of what happened fucking 9 hours before this.
In fact, you came screaming for my attention, which is why you made a video with no argument and a ton of ad hominem attacks.
Right. I mean, you could say I have a bunch of ad hominem attacks in this video, because I do. But, you know, considering the fact that you go on to say I have a pathetic life, that I'm a non-existent entity, that I don't fucking matter, that I suck and my videos suck, and that I'm only gay to rebel against my parents, you're just, you know, so have so much room to talk on the ad hominem attacks department.
Don't even try to pretend like you're done with me. That's a joke. You are a butthurt, pissed off.
Says the guy who is gonna yell at his neighbor and, you know, make himself basically fucking piss off everyone.
Angry little kid, because you made no arguments and you made yourself look stupid.
Says the guy who is using market values to describe why his videos are so popular and my videos are so unpopular. I have to say, you have to be the ultimate capitalist, because you're basically someone who's profiting off of communism. So, I have to fucking give you props for that.
This is my point. You did come begging for my attention. You right-wing losers do this all the time. You see me as like some kind of Marxist god of YouTube, and—
No, Jason. I've already established that I don't even consider you to be a fucking intelligent communist. I just see you as a fucking moron.
You're gonna solely go for it and take them down.
Just as they are ready to do any time, free men anywhere waver in their defense of democracy. Yes, once again, American defense proves its effectiveness against international communism. Using this diagram of a tooth to represent any small country, we can see how international communism works by eroding away from the inside. When one country or tooth falls victim to international communism, its neighbors soon follow. In dentistry, this is known as the domino theory. But with American defense, the decay is stopped before it starts. And that's why 9 out of 10 small countries choose American defense.
You have such a sense of entitlement to me, to my attention. You have to have my attention. I don't care about you.
Right, because you posting video responses 12 hours afterwards fucking says otherwise.
I don't watch your channel. I don't care about you. You are a fucking non-entity. You don't mean anything to me. You need my attention. And as much as you try to pretend otherwise, it's a joke. That's why you made a video to me. Remember that.
Yeah. So there's his neighbor telling him to be quiet or he's calling the cops. It makes me wonder what was going on in your house or apartment or wherever the fuck you live. It makes me wonder, because I wonder if those Berlin walls could talk.
Remember that. Come at me, bro!
And there's the response of a mature adult. You know, I mean, this is probably why you have no friends in fucking real life. Or, you know, I mean, you might have a few of your little commie friends. But, you know, I mean, I don't really see you as somebody who's actually able to get along in society very well. Because you're obviously a fucking retarded douchebag. So, yeah, I'll be waiting for you 12 hours from now to make a reply to me. Or who knows, maybe you'll give up and 9 months later you'll make a reply to me. Either way, I don't think I've heard the last from you.